He was shot in the head while struggling with an unruly rioter last night, and the officer was rushed to a nearby hospital. He was put on life support. That same night, a heavily armed man opened fire on Las Vegas PD, but this time, the cops got the upper hand, and they shot and killed the suspect. Across the country in Buffalo, New York, at least police officers were injured when an SUV plowed over them during last night's protest. And an NYPD officer in the Bronx was struck by a vehicle in a hit and run. Another officer there was viciously attacked by a group of thugs as looting and vandalism ran rampant through the city. So what do all these events have in common? They come as radical leftists and even prominent Democrats are continuing to fan the flames of racial division and paint this picture of America as a horrible, awful, racist country that is irredeemable. And of course, if you're a policeman or woman, you're part of the problem in their worldview. It's a poisonous narrative. And it's not just tainting the airwaves. It's having real-world consequences. And it's putting blue lives in danger. Joining me now is Ed Mullins, president of the New York Sergeants Benevolent Association, and Jerry McCarthy, former NYPD precinct commander and former Newark police commissioner. Ed, is there a heightened anxiety or concern, fear among the NYPD that they might now be singled out and targeted by these rioters or people just looking to use the protests as cover?
Laura, everything you just said is 100% true, but NYPD is losing the city of New York, and we have no leadership in the city of New York right now, from City Hall through the brass of the NYPD. The men and women are being pelted with rocks, bricks, cars lit on fire, and this is continuous. We have a curfew that's been implemented tonight at 8 o'clock, and everyone is still out rioting in the streets of New York. If President Trump is watching this, I am asking the president to please immediately send federal personnel to New York.